Hello guys, and welcome to episode 2 of the Pokemon Platinum Insanity Nuzlocke. Now if you have not watched the first episode, you're going to need to if you want an explanation of all the rules. Please don't rely on the description, even though it is pretty descriptive in my opinion. But still, you want to watch the first episode, please. One thing though that I decided on in between this and last episode, I am not using the two Bidoofs I caught. They are clearly, they're going to be nothing more than death fodder and or HM slaves. It is because Bidoofs are terrible. I'm sorry, they are terrible. That's one reason. Reason two is I want Chiquita to get a lot of experience. And, I'd like him to be like my star player if possible. So, if I try to train everyone at once, it's gonna be very hard for Chiquita to get experience and stuff. I'm sure you know. I think you know what I'm trying to say. I want Chiquita to get a lot of experience, and when I find someone else that might be helpful, then yes, I will use them. But right now, no. I do not want anyone. I do not want. Yeah, the two Bidoofs, Cabela and Ramada, they are death fodder. Let's see. Should I use a potion before her? Now I'll use a potion in the middle of it if I need to. I side with my little Aya trainer. A battle, please. Sure. So yeah, that first guy had a Starly, which I wish I had. And she has a Bidoof, which I wish I didn't have. Oh well. You never know. Maybe they'll come in handy. Because, like I said, HM slaves they might be. Let's see, I think I could survive 3 more attacks. Or 3 more will kill me, is what I meant to say. Yes, and I'll use a potion after this battle. Alright. Yeah, because since there's going to be several deaths in this Nuzlocke, I can already tell you that much. There's going to be several deaths, and I have a very bad feeling Chiquita's going to be one of those deaths. Oh, boo, I can't win. There might be a point where I won't have anyone that could learn a TM that I'll need to know, an HM that can get past a certain point. Because they're required to get through the game. So, maybe it's a good thing that I have these two guys here. And I'm walking through grass, not running, because according to Heart Gold and Soul Silver, more Pokemon appear when you run. I don't know if that's true in games that came before it, but I'm just assuming. And this guy's a Burmy. That's good for me, because I'm super effective against it. I wouldn't mind having a Burmy, as long as it was male, because I like Mothim. I don't like Wormadam, though. So, wow, level 9 already. See, this is why I wanted Chiquita to be the only one I'm using right now. And I have Taunt. Don't know if I'll ever actually use that, but you never know. I found something. That's okay. It's another Bidoof. I have found nothing but Bidoofs in the wild so far. Nothing but them. At least this one's a girl. It's slightly different. I beat it in one hit, it was a critical hit. Yay! Yeah, I can't run from wild Pokemon, so I have to fight everyone that I find. Are you important? Oh yeah, times that I play, yeah. Yeah, I don't know what time you'll see mostly when I play. Probably the daytime. Finally something that I wanted, but I can't catch. Starly, I wish I had one of you. Starly and Shinx. So if I could pick anything that I would have caught on those two routes, that's what I would have wanted. Starly and Shinx. Because Starly is a very good Pokemon. I used one in the very first time I played Diamond. And yeah. And Shinx, Luxray is my favorite 4th gen Pokemon of all, so. Yeah! We are now in Jubilife City, and oh, hey, Dawn. You're catching Pokemon. I caught a couple. Oh, really? I can only catch one per route, you idiot. Oh, I get a new healing point. There's a new Pokemon Center. Oh, and it's Looker. I have to admit, Looker is a funny character, but he literally plays no role in Platinum. Like, he was added in Platinum, he wasn't in Diamond and Pearl, but I think he's meant to be a joke, because he's supposed to be a member of the international police, but he doesn't do anything. He basically tries to, I don't know. He tries to track down Team Galactic this whole time, but he always pops up after we have already defeated them. At least that's what I remember from Platinum. Yeah, so I think he's a pointless character, but he is funny, so I don't mind him being in the game. See? It was a form of bad guys. See, he's really just a lonely guy trying to get attention by being international police. That's what I think he is, based on what he just said. That was my theory. Trainer school. You saw Barry go in there? Alright. I have to go back to school? Oh, school? But I just graduated. It was gonna pain me to go in there, but I guess I have to talk to Barry. Barry, what are you doing at school? Oh, wait, we're kids in this game. I guess it makes sense. Hey, Michael, did you come to study? No, I didn't! I came to find you and give you this parcel. Take the stupid parcel. It's a town map. Yay, I got a town map. I don't know why they call it a town map, because it's a map of the whole region, not a town. But I guess it was called that from the very beginning, so I guess they were too lazy to change its name. Okay, now those two trainers over there, I remember in Diamond and Pearl, if you beat them both, you get hidden power. I think. But I don't want to fight them, because I think they have level 10s. And yeah, I only have level 9. Global terminal. Oh, that's okay. I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't do any trades like that anyway. I feel like that would be unfair to Nuzlocke. The only reason I would think trading is okay to Nuzlocke is to evolve certain Pokemon. So, since this is a real version, like I mentioned at the end, of last episode, I forgot what I was saying, because I was reading what the guy said. I have to answer a question for all these clowns, and the answer is yes for all of them. I remember that from when I played before. I don't know how I remember that, but I remember they ask really stupid, obvious questions. Oh, I was saying it's okay to trade because this is a real version. So if I catch a Graveler or something, or a Machoke, I can evolve it if I want, because I can trade Pokemon. Yeah. And here's the third clown. Wow, that was hard. Yay, I got the coupons. Yay. Now I can get a Poketch. I have to admit, I really like the Poketch. HeartGold, SoulSilver have my favorite menu on the bottom because you can just tap anything you want that you would normally have to bring up by pushing X. But the Poketch is my second favorite because it has all sorts of different, like, apps that you can do for it. And it's really useful. I feel like they should have something like this in X and Y. Did you hear that, Pokemon Company? If you haven't, and Game Freak, if there's some things you haven't added yet, I'd like to see one of those. Where'd you come from? Twinleaf Town. It's quiet and all. There might be some items in this town. I might go looking around. Pachirisu and Pikachu. Oh, a Quick Claw! Wow, that's a good item. I'm not gonna give it to Chimchar, though, because he's fast already. Yeah. Anything up here interesting? Heal ball. Heal balls! Those are helpful in this type of Nuzlocke. Especially before I get, because you know, guys, I can't heal. And if I catch a Pokemon, and it ends up in my party, meaning before I have 6 total, I'll have to heal it myself. After damaging it to catch it. So, what do I have? I have 240. Oh, I don't have enough to buy a heal ball. I think they're 300. Yeah, wow. It's kind of expensive. Okay, I'll come back later, maybe. Just maybe. I don't know how much exploring I'm really gonna do. I just kind of wanted to go up there. I thought I'd find something, and I did. I found a Quick Claw. Do you anything fun to say? Hello, trainer, about Pokemon. Do I know much about Pokemon? I kind of just want to walk away and not answer him, but fine, I'll say yes. Yeah, I'm gonna leave now. I was just insulted by an old man who asked, "Do you know much about Pokemon?" All right, round 204, we can catch a new Pokemon. Please be someone useful. Please, please be someone useful. It is Starly. Yes, it's a male. But so far, we're once again doing a Team Sausage Fest thing. But that's okay. I am quite all right with Starly. I am quite all right indeed with Starly. And. Excuse me while I kill myself. Okay, I'm back. Are you serious?! Chiquita, why did you do that?! You killed us! That was the biggest load of crap I've ever seen! Oh my god! Serious? That is ridiculous. Oh my god. Oh, a weak-looking trainer. It's because of my Bidoofs, isn't it? Thanks, Sarah. Shing, you dare to use a Shinx like that. That is... I'm not happy. I'm not happy one bit. Oh well, I guess we didn't get Starly. It's not a big deal. Let's look on the bright side. We got experience from killing it. That's the important part. Oh, I should have said no. You asked me! So you should have said no to your own question? Sure. Doesn't this guy have Magikarps? I'll beat you with the Magikarp, yeah. Somehow I remember that. Maybe I actually remember more about Platinum than I thought. Oh! I remember one of my dislikes about Platinum, and I notice it right now with Magikarp. A lot of the Pokemon sprites in this game are just the second frame of animation from their Diamond and Pearl sprite. And it doesn't look right to be their standing still sprite. Like, look at that Magikarp sprite. Magikarp does not look right, in my opinion, with his mouth closed. It's just, in Diamond and Pearl, his animation, he has his mouth open and he juggles back and forth, opening and closing his mouth. That would make sense for his second frame animation, but not his standing still one. That was one of my things I remember I disliked about Platinum. But, whatever. And here's a Pokemon that I have to fight. It is... Oh, look, a Starly, level 5. Go educate it, critical at this one, too! Oh, and that one has Quick Attack. Nice. You're killing me, Chiquita! I'll never buy bananas again! Alright, should I use a potion before this girl? Just be on the safe side, I will. I feel like I have plenty. I don't want to, like... I don't want to abuse potions, though, because... I ran out very quickly in my white test that I was telling you guys about. And if some of you are wondering why I tested this out, is because I wanted to make sure these rules were actually possible to do. Oh, I didn't need to heal for this. What I learned from the test was that it's possible, but very, very hard. So, and I'm running out of PP for Ember. I have 11 PP now after I used that. Oh, I didn't kill it in one hit, but he didn't even use an attacking move, so it didn't matter. Whatever. Bye-bye, Bidoo. Sounds like Bidoof, but not. Yeah, Chiquita's growing lots of levels. And Rourke, the first gym leader, is at 14. So I better not get to past that. Oh. Ravaged path. There are boulders blocking the way inside the cavern. Oh, I just remembered! This isn't the right way, is it? Yeah, the Sinnoh region is confusing, but I can catch a Pokemon in here! Probably a Zubat or a Geodude, is what I'm guessing is in here. Right? That's what's usually in caves. We found something! What is it? It is! A Zubat, a female Zubat, level 3. Alright! I'm afraid I might kill it. You know what? So let's switch out. We're gonna switch out to Cabela. I do not want to miss another Pokemon catch. I don't even know if I'll use this Zubat, but I do still want it. Let's use a Tackle. It's just gonna keep using Leech Life. I'm quite alright with that. How much does this Tackle do? Eh, I can do it a few more times. And see, here's the one of the occasions where ROM would be helpful, because I would just speed up this part. But it's not a big deal. Oh, 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 oh! See? See? This is why I used Cabela. Let's use a Pokeball on this, and I'm going to have to heal her if I want to use her at all. Although, I'm going to have to be using Switch Training to train her anyway, so I guess it doesn't matter that much. Yeah, I caught a Zubat, a female. So good, we're not Team Sausage Fest after all. I still wish I would have caught Starly. I would have been so excited about Starly, but... fate does not like me, this Nuzlocke, I guess. Alright, let's nickname our new Zubat. What can we name a Zubat? Let's see. I gotta think on this. I need to look some stuff up. Alright, I got a name. I'm naming her Aurora. What is Aurora, you ask? Well, I was thinking, what do bats do? They suck blood. I was thinking, there's such a thing as a blood company, is there? Oh, a hospital. How about a hospital? So then there's a hospital in our area called Aurora Health Center. So I thought Aurora was nice. It also sounds like a female name. So hardy nature, that's not bad at all. You know what? I want to use her. She's way better than the Bidoofs. And I don't want to use one of my healing points because... all of her HP can be restored with just a potion. So you know what? Maybe I'm glad I didn't get a heal ball because potions and heal balls are cost the exact same. So it wouldn't have mattered whether I'd used the potion on her just now or if I had caught her with a heal ball. And cool, I didn't find anything. Alright, we're back in Jubilife. Do I go right? That must be, because I know left goes to Canalave. Wait a minute. Does Barry fight me here? No, he doesn't. Oh! Yes, he does. Alright, this might not be a... this might not be good. Oh well, whatever. Remember, guys, I won't be able to switch out when he sends out his second Pokemon, so... whatever. Here we go! And then after we fight Barry, we'll try to catch yet another Pokemon on this route. And he has a Starly. Way to rub it in my face, Barry. Alright, we're sending out Aurora. Now we're gonna switch to Chiquita. Alright, what's he gonna use? Growl. That's okay, I'm gonna use Ember anyway. That's a special attack. And I gotta remember, it's been a while since I've done a 4th or 5th gen game, because the last two Nuzlockes I did were 3rd gen, and I'm so used to them being, all, basically the special and attack and special attack split was different in the 3rd gen. They changed it in 4th and 5th gen, and it was a good change by far, I would agree to that, but, I'm not used to it, so I have to keep remembering that. Fire moves are not necessarily all special. I have to look at what they are, so... and see, did you notice that? It did not ask me, hey, he's about to use Piplup. Would you like to switch? He just sent him right out. Bam, he's out. So... oh, crap, and my attack is lowered. Crap. Well, guess what? We're gonna use Ember. And that hardly did anything. And he's just getting... is this what Piplup does? Constantly use Growl? Come on, burn him! Oh, pound. Does he know? I could have sworn Piplup knows Bubble by now. Maybe not, but I could have sworn. He's not even trying. Kind of kills the mood. And I have 5 PP left with Ember. And after this, now I have 4 left. So, I might have to use a healing point just to get the PP back. But I really don't want to. And now Chiquita's going to get a crap ton of experience, which I wish had been split with Aurora, but that's okay. Wah! What do you mean I lost? Well, that's it. That's the last time I'll ever lose. Yeah. Okay. Keep talking. Alright, now we're going to catch someone else. But we're going to put a Cabela up front. Because, yeah, it's not a huge deal if he dies. And other stuff. Who is it? It is another freaking Bidoof. You know, I guess what? I can't even run. Remember that? I can't even run. Wow! That was the most stereotypical thing I've ever seen. Two Bidoofs fighting. Miss and miss. You know what? If Cabela dies, I will not be sad. Bye! Goodbye! I'm sorry, I don't care! Now we're gonna go to Ramada. And now we're gonna use a Pokeball. Yay! I caught another freaking Bidoof! Yes, let's name it. Alright, I absolutely no idea what to name her, so I looked up a list of lumber companies, because beavers chew wood, lumber is wood, and I found one called Deltic Corporation, so Deltic is her name. Well, let's go put Cabela in the box, because he is dead. Now some of you, I have gotten requests in all of my Nuzlockes, why don't I play with a duplicates rule? I answered this in the middle of my Ruby Hack Nuzlocke a little bit, but basically, I could understand why someone would want to. It's because you'd avoid things like this. You wouldn't have 3 Bidoofs. I would have gotten a redo. So, wouldn't that sound like a fun idea if I get a redo? Wrong! I hate the concept of a redo. I would have rather caught that Bidoof than having a second chance. Because that, to me, kills the whole point of a Nuzlocke. A Nuzlocke, you're not supposed to know what you're gonna get. If you don't like it, too bad. That is my opinion, at least, when it comes to Nuzlockes. Let's look at Deltic, just for the fun of it. A modest nature, plus special attack, minus attack. That's actually not that bad, because Bibarel is part water, so it'd be a decent surf attack, basically. Whatever. I don't know. I don't know what more to say. Yeah, I am okay with catching multiple Bidoofs. I would rather do that than get a second chance, because it is totally against what I believe a Nuzlocke is supposed to be. It's supposed to be random, and based, a lot of it is on luck. Based on what Pokemon you end up getting. So, that's my opinion, at least. Oh, well, thank you for telling me who you're going to use. Krikatot and Zubat. Thank you. And his name is Michael. Hey, that's my name. Both in the game and, well, yeah. All right, Aurora. Let's switch out to Chicky. And Bide? You know, just to be on the safe side, I am not going to attack. I'm just going to use Leer. I know Leer won't matter because Ember's special base, but I don't care. I do not want to accidentally not kill it with Ember. Unleash energy? Ha! Now let's see if I was right to do that. No, I killed him anyway. But still, if I hadn't killed in one hit, he would have killed me in one hit. So, now the only one of the sucky parts about not being able to switch out when he sends in a new Pokemon is I can't switch back to, whosamacallit, Aurora, and then switch back to Chiquita to get Switch experience. But that's okay. I'm switching because I know all he's gonna have is, Supersonic and Leech Life. It wouldn't have mattered if I had to do this or not. And yeah, I wasn't worried about a Leech Life because it wouldn't have done hardly any damage. And a Supersonic, the switching out would have gotten rid of the confusion anyway. Let's use Scratch. Let's conserve the embers. There's only three left. And I think after we beat him, we're gonna end this part here. I know this Nuzlocke is going by really slowly, I noticed. You know, that might be partly because I'm doing it on a real game. Or because I'm not speeding up and everything. And because I'm being a lot more careful with everything. I say Aurora's number level 5, that's nice. One thing I might do... This might sound silly, but I might run around in circles. Before I say why, can anyone figure out why I might do something silly like that? It's because in this game, just having a Pokemon in your party raises their happiness. If I run around in circles long enough, I'll evolve to Crobat almost immediately after becoming Golbat with Aurora. And at this moment, it looks like these are going to be my dynamic duo for a while at least, because I keep finding Bidoofs otherwise. And one of them died already, but that's okay. I'm okay with one of them dying. I am fine with having two Bidoofs in my party. I am not okay with having three, because one of them has to die in order to be free to use more because of my no deposit rule. So yeah, we will end this part. I'm pretty sure I have two healing points. I'll know when I edit the video because the number you see on the screen, I don't see as I'm playing. I add it in as I'm editing it. So, we will continue Route 203 in the next part. And I save after every episode. I saved after I stopped recording last episode. I only save between episodes. I'm not gonna ever save in the middle of one, or else I can easily, or I don't know, why would I? It would kill the whole point. So, and yeah, save time in the Sinnoh games take a long time, but who cares? So yeah, hope you enjoyed, see y'all next time, and of course, rock on!